Hey, everybody, this is Lady J, and we're filming an episode of Lady J Live Radio tonight because I have in the house legendary players. I mean, legendary, back to the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, the 90s, and they're here in Hollywood celebrating their 40th anniversary. I'm talking about the Ohio Players. I know you remember Fire and Skin Tight and Honey. Well, they're going to share a lot of this tonight on the radio if you're here listening on Saturday tonight, actually, at 7 p.m. on Lady J Live. Live.com. All the Way Live Productions is here, and we're going to have fun tomorrow night at the Grammys, so I do want to see your face there. Look for us on TV. Look for us on the red carpet, okay? Everybody stay tuned for the radio show. Peace. Lady J, and I'm back with the legendary Ohio Players here from Ohio celebrating their 40th anniversary here in Hollywood. I want to welcome them to the show. First and foremost, we have Marshall Jones, who is the bass player, and we have Greg Webster, the drummer, and we have vocalist Vanderveer here in the house. They're going to be having a great time tomorrow along with myself at the Grammy Award ceremony and also at the after party. And so I want to make sure that you guys know who you're dealing with here. I'm talking 40 years of funk. I'm talking fire. I'm talking skin tight. I'm talking heaven must be like this. That's my cut, everybody. We're going to start a quick interview with them before we go into the radio show. And if you don't know by now, you can always check me out at LadyJLive.com. You can go to MySpace.com/LadyJLive and check it out. Also, you need to check out Skin Tight Leathers. And if you don't know, you will know by tomorrow watching the Grammys, okay? Also, before I do another shameless plug, I'm going to let you know that All The Way Live Productions is responsible for this along with myself. So I want you guys, if you don't know, now you know, and you need to tell somebody about it. Welcome to the show. Ohio Players is in the house. What's happening, fellas? Miss Philly, yeah, that'll be me. Okay. I want to start with all of you and give us an idea of how this all started for the Ohio Players. And I know this is going to go way back.
A long way back.
Yeah.
Marshall here was with the group called The Untouchables. And like when they left, I tried to get Sugarfoot, and we decided to get together and form the group, The Ohio Players.
Okay. Well, you know what? The music and the name is synonymous with funk. Funk is a strong word, and it's coming back because people are really looking forward to hearing real music again. And they're sampling a lot of music from the funk. Yeah. So tell me, and a lot of listeners, especially young people, what funk like really is, so they'll be clear on that.
I'd like to say it by telling this story. We were signed with a company in Detroit called Westbound Label. And at the time, we were with Westbound, George Clinton, and the Parliaments happened to be on the same label. Now, George Clinton and the Parliaments, they had the hairdos, and they had suits and ties on, and they were doing the Temptation type of thing. Uh-huh. And we came along, and we were on the same label, mind you. We came along with this tune, Funky Worm. And I remember that tune because people used to bring all their kids to the matinees, right? George is a very smart man. Now, he was from Jersey, had a barbershop up there. He knew a group in Jersey called the Funkadelics, who at the time were trying to do an acid rock white thing. As black artists, they was trying to go into that genre, that market. George called him on the phone and said, "Hey, man, y'all gotta come to Detroit. This is the sound that's gonna happen." And at the same time, we did the Funky Worm. We had a member of the group called Junie Morrison. Junie did the granny part on the Funky Worm.
Oh, okay.
So it got so popular, Junie left the group, decided to form his own group. He put out a record called Bread Alone. It went up and it, behind that, he was out of work, right? George Clinton, like I said, was a very smart man. He came up and said, "Junie, come here." Meantime, Bootsy Collins, who I am his mentor to a degree. I can't say I taught him, but we were sharing ideas at the time. Bootsy was 18, I was maybe 4 or 5 years older than he was.
Okay.
Bootsy went with James Brown. He stayed with James for about a year. James wanted me to join the group, but I was kind of scared of James for knowing his policy. So Bootsy went with him. Bootsy stayed with him for about a year or so, and he left. Next thing I know, Boosie's with George Clinton. Like I said, George Clinton's a very smart man. He understood the funk. He knew what it was going to do. And he took it to the next level. George Clinton made it all the way funky. And they got together and they put out One Nation Under a Groove. Now, they had a couple urban hits before then. But when they come out with One Nation Under a Groove with Junie and Boosie on there, that was the big O on the big D, funk. And that's how the funk kind of took its own course.
Okay, so it started there, and then everybody caught on, you know, because I grew up in the funk era, you know, and, you know, One Nation and Bootsy Collins, and I know I heard the story myself about how he started with James Brown, and James is a hard man to work with, right? He was the hardest working man in the industry. And there's a lot of history about the funk, but I want to touch base. You were talking about one of the songs that you guys did, the Funky Worm. Well, there's an urban myth that has been circulating throughout my life about Love Roller Coaster, and the scream, the woman screaming in the background.
I guess that's the reason why the tabloids sell. You can start a rumor, and that rumor can take off and sell records.
All right, you care to share what the rumor is?
That's what it was, a rumor. It was a rumor. You know, they a DJ, I think, in San Francisco started that rumor. And it sold the records.
Okay. Well, he won't say exactly what it is, you know.
I'm not in jail.
No, you're not in jail. Oh, see, now you just revealed something to me, because I know that there was an individual responsible for the scream. I didn't know which one of you were the one, were the culprit. Oh, was it you?
I wasn't even in a picture.
Well, that scream was supposed to be real. Something was supposed to be happening to this particular woman that was back there screaming. You know, so there was just a lot of stuff going on with that, and it kept people listening, and of course your record sales grew as a result.
Exactly.
I'm gonna talk about something else about the music, and I want to know who started this first. Okay. Ow. That's legendary with the Ohio Players.
Sugarfoot.
Okay, some people might question that it started with Larry Blackman and Cameo, but I know you guys were around longer than them.
I think most people already know that Larry Blackman had nothing to do with the start of the album.
Wow.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, Earth, Wind, and Fire even picked it up on
yes,
one of their songs.
Absolutely.
So, you know, the Players done started a lot of things. Matter of fact, when we did the Funky Worm and Pain, hey, everybody jumped on top of it, and that's where it started from there.
A lot of people don't know about this cut called Angel. Yeah, that's a serious cut right there. Yeah, there's a whole lot of them. I'm going to share with you in a little bit. The show is going to be featuring the Ohio Players, and I'm going to hit all the old school cuts. So you might have to forgive me on the radio because I'm going to be singing. So, and I suggest you sing along as well. I'm going to give my friend over here, Vanderveer, an opportunity, if he don't mind, to speak a little bit about Skin Tight Leathers that I'm going to be looking so beautiful in tomorrow.
Well, the name came from the hit record from the Ohio Players. At that time, they were one of my first clients, you know, that I did clothes for. You know, I've done stuff for Stevie Wonder, Chaka Khan, Isley Brothers, Sonny and Cher, Glenn Campbell, Marvin Gaye, Ohio Players, on and on and on and on and on, you know. But these guys were my favorite clients, you know. And we kind of grew, you know, grew onto each other. And, you know, Marsha took me in the studio and had me do a cut on one of the albums. You know, and we decided that eventually, somewhere in the future, that we were going to do something really great together, you know. So right now we're putting together some gigs in Vegas, and we're putting together some gigs for the Academy. We're getting ready to do it this time, you know. And we hope that you all get a chance to see us on the red carpet, because we're going to really be tearing up.
Yes, they are. Yes, they are. I'm looking forward to it. This is my new family, everybody. This is the Higher Players. I want you to give them love. You can still go on iTunes and you can purchase any of their music. Make sure you do that. Still show your love and your respect. This is the Ohio Players, everybody, one of my favorite groups. I'll talk to you later. Make sure you stay in touch with LadyJLive.com. This is All The Way Live Productions. And one more thing.
I would like to say to the audience that we love you first. And I want to tell this story to everyone. We have a forthcoming book coming out, In the Line of Fire. And it'll be at your newsstand soon. So stay tuned. Ohio Players is still live.
Okay, In the Line of Fire. Perfectly put. Okay, everybody, I look forward to checking you out another time, another place with another group. You guys stay tuned. I love you. Peace, people.